Hello everyone. Today's topic of discussion is magic bullet theory. This theory is also known as hypodermic needle theory. This is more of a model rather than a theory because it is not based on any empirical research or it is not a result of any extensive mass media audience survey. But this theory is important because it is considered as one of the earliest mass communication theories which have emerged in America. Because America is considered as immediate consumer of any technology, and it is so in the case of mass media also. After tremendous popularity of films, radio entered into America in 1920s. In 1921, the first radio station was set up in America. Immediately, radio has become one of the major information providers for Americans, and it has become all pervasive in day-to-day life of Americans. All these developments, impact of films as well as radio on the American citizens were keenly observed by mass media theorists, and this prompted for formation of theory called magic bullet theory or hypodermic needle theory. So now let us look into what is magic bullet theory, what does it says, what are its features and assumptions, and what are its limitations. Basically, magic bullet theory or hypodermic needle theory presumes that media is powerful and strong and it has direct and immediate impact on the people. The theory was developed in 1920s and 30s and it was proposed by Harold Laswell in his book Propaganda Techniques in the World War, and it was published in 1927. The theory is a linear model of communication and talks about media's power on the audience. Linear model of communication means there is one way flow of communication and it is from top to bottom, and there is vertical flow of communication. The message in the theory is said to be like a magic bullet which enters into the minds of the people and injects a message into the brains. So the theory explains how media controls what the audience views and listens to and their effect, which may be immediate or it may be long-term effect. The magic bullet theory graphically assumes that the media messages is like a bullet fired from media gun into the viewer's head. The word bullet and the needle are also used to show powerfulness of the media as well as powerlessness of the audience. So you can see the graphical representation of hypodermic needle model in your screen. So there is syringe and it is directly injected into the brain of audience. So in the syringe contains certain pictures and text, so which is injected into the audience brain. So now let us see what are the factors contributed for this strong effect theory. So the first reason is the fast rise and popularization of radio and television, which we have discussed earlier. Within short span of 2 years, nearly 60% of Americans owned radio set. So obviously there is direct impact of radio on people's day-to-day life. Then there is emergence of persuasion industry, so such as advertising and propaganda. So persuasion industries, you know, it is a branch of marketing where which influences people to buy product, or it influences people to have an action, to follow an idea or to follow one leader. The next reason is fine fund studies which were conducted in 1930s, which focused on impact of motion picture on the children and society in large. The fine fund studies are studies funded by American Motion Picture Council. They wanted to look how media can affect people in a long term. So the study run for several years, and then they have submitted one report, and report proved that there is immediate impact of media on the people. And there were instances of violence in the society as well as some unethical behavior in the society. Then there is one more reason to which contributed for development of this strong effect theory, that is Hitler's monopolization of mass media during World War II to unify the Germany. So if you read his book Mein Kampf, you can realize that how he has used propaganda tool in a scientific term. So he has used all the possible set of media. He has used print, he has used radio, he has used film to propagate his Nazi Germany or Third Reich. So now let us see the assumptions and features of magic bullet theory. The first assumption of this magic bullet theory is individuals are atomized. So according to this theory, in an industrialized and capitalistic country, people live lonely. So if you read the effect of industrialization, people left their friends, relatives and family behind and they have moved to cities. So, and they didn't have anybody to rely on. So they have depended on media and then they were considered as voracious consumers of media. The second assumption which the theory proposes is audience are uniform. According to this theory, audience receives the same message from same media, and then there is like similar attitude and beliefs which can be created by media messages. So audience are uniform, they are not diversified. The third assumption is audience are passive. According to this theory, people are not rational, they don't think, they just receive whatever like media dumped in front of them. They don't think and they just receive the messages unquestioningly. And then fourth reason is there is no other source of information. According to this theory, there are no other alternative media to compare media text. So, but all these assumptions in later period proved flaw. But to support this theory, there was an interesting example happened in America in 1938, and that example is considered as classic example for existence of hypodermic needle theory or magic bullet theory. So that incident proved that radio can impact people directly and immediately. So it was in 1938, a radio drama called War of the World was broadcasted in Columbia Broadcasting Service. CBS is one of the national network in America. The name of the drama was War of the World. It was adaptation by H.G. Wells and directed by Orson Welles. It was which was telecasted on October 30th and it was on Halloween day. The gist of drama was that there is life in Mars and Martians can come and attack on the Earth. The radio drama was presented as a news bulletin. There was narration from radio jockey and in the meantime there were interview with the experts. But remember, it was a scientific fiction drama. It is said that nearly 1 million people listened to that radio drama and they believed that actually Martians are attacking Earth and there are like spacecrafts which were carrying the aliens into the Earth. So nearly million people, they rushed into street, there were traffic blockade, there were stampede in the New Jersey city. And there were people, they wanted to witness the alien attack on the Earth, and there are some people, they want to, you know, find a safer place. So finally, this radio drama created panic among the people. So even though this radio drama proved that there is, you know, existence of magic bullet theory, but still there were criticism on this theory. So if you look at the criticism of hypodermic needle theory, the theory assumed that the people are passive and they are easily influenced by the messages, which might not be true every time. Sometimes people are rational, they think. So, and then the second criticism is that the theory has been proved to fail by many studies like People's Choice. The People's Choice is a study which wanted to test media influence on the people, and surprisingly that study proved that media has lesser role on people's decision, but the peers and the interpersonal influence have a high hand on people's decisions. And then the third criticism is that the theory is not taken as an empirical study because it is not based on any aggressive mass communication research. And finally, there are many media options which are available after growth of media outlets today. So people won't depend on single media and they are not exposed to single media messages. So in conclusion, the theory is based on the assumption on human behavior and it is not based on any empirical research. So today it is completely disapproved and discredited by the theorist. But the existence of magic bullet theory can be realized in extreme situations like war and disaster, etc. But in the normal location, this theory always proved wrong. So with this, I will conclude today's session. So we'll meet again with another concept. Thank you. Thank you for watching.